evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to get tonight underway, so if I could have your attention, please. Thank you so much for joining us for the Stars of High River Volunteer Appreciation Event. Look at this room, it's packed. Give yourselves a round of applause. Before we officially start, I just want to let you know, if you haven't been here before, washrooms are just out this front door and you hang a right. Exits are clearly marked if we have a situation where we need to exit the building promptly. And just an FYI, there is a defibrillator on set. Great. Yeah. You know, safety first, you just never know in case that happens. But my name is Jody Seely. I'm with Our High River, and I'm very honored to be your MC tonight and joining you for a very cool event. You know, volunteers are really the essential souls of our community, and we are so blessed in High River to have the group of volunteers that we do. So I want you to clap for yourselves one more time. Tonight was not only created to hand out the five awards for the Town of High River's official Volunteers of the Year, but also an opportunity to recognize all the incredible nominations we got this year. And so congratulations to all of the nominees. And thank you to all of the people who took time to submit a nomination. We really appreciate that. So let's hear it for all of them. And this event was also really created by the Town of High River to say thank you back to the community for everybody who does volunteer. So we are officially on Facebook Live right now as well to say thank you to all of the volunteers who we couldn't fit into this room tonight. Fauna and I were chatting earlier online that we really think we could probably fill Highwood High's field with all of the volunteers that we have. We couldn't cram you all into this room. So we just also want to take a moment to thank anybody, whether you volunteered for an hour or somebody who's had hundreds of hours. Thank you for giving back to your community. I found this quote on volunteering that I wanted to share tonight because I thought it was kind of timely with what's happening in our province as well. And it says, volunteering is the ultimate exercise in democracy. You vote in elections once a year, but when you volunteer, you vote every day about the kind of community that you want to live in. So again, thank you for volunteering. First of all, I would like to take a moment to introduce to you your mayor and invite him up to say a few words. If you could put your hands together for Mayor Craig Snodgrass.
Thanks, Jody. I had a bunch of notes written on my phone and forgot my glasses. I can't see a darn thing. Thank you all for coming. I was shocked when I drove up because I actually thought there had to be a tournament on at the golf course because there was no possible way that this many people would show up to an event like this and walk in the door, and lo and behold, this is what it is. And I thank you all for coming and dedicating your time tonight to come and celebrate this. The volunteers in our town are the ones that make it happen. Your council and town administration, our role is really just to set the stage and get out of the way and let you folks make it happen. And it really doesn't matter what role you take in that, whether you're with the hospital auxiliary, whether you're on the board of directors at the golf club or volunteering at the golf club, or so many different areas of this town that rely on volunteers. Handing bus, another big one, but I'm familiar with. Doesn't matter how you do it either. You can do it quietly and you can come in and just make it happen. You don't take any bells or whistles or anything, and you just go about, you make our community great, and you move on. Or you can climb up to the top of the high diving board and, like Hank Liebfrink, and come bailing off yelling cannonball and blow into the deep end, coming up gasping for air and begging for forgiveness because he did something and making Craig's head explode. It's all dramatic. The results are exactly the same, and the reasons why you do it are exactly the same, and it's the fact that everybody in this room loves this town and wants to make this town and everybody in it love it as much as they do. And how you go about that and do it, it doesn't matter. don't care. It's the fact that every one of you in here have put your hands up to make the town that I grew up in and live in and raise my family in. For me, it's the greatest place on earth. There's no doubt. I won't go anywhere else. I'm kind of trapped here now. But. I want to thank you all for coming. I could go on forever, but thank you very much and enjoy your night. And congratulations to all the recipients tonight. We're going to have a great time. So thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. Well, let's get to our official awards presentation. Joining us to present our first award tonight is Councillor Don Moore.
My little iPad is put out. But a large component of the amazing atmosphere of the High River Hospital is thanks to a group of volunteers that show up in a number of areas at the hospital. I've got some. Thank you for volunteering. You know, I talked to Grace Ledoux, who is the coordinator of the High River Volunteer Hospital Volunteers group, and I was totally amazed to hear that there is over 200 volunteers at the hospital. And that includes a wide spectrum of ages as well, because there's programs at the high schools in High River that where you have to put in 30 or 50 hours of volunteer work at the hospital if you're going into a program in the health services. So they come and they volunteer and they get to find out a little bit more about where they would like to be later. So it's an amazing program. The person that nominated the group and said this, recently came to my attention how important the palliative care team is to the families of High River. The support they provided to the family of a friend of mine was phenomenal. However, that team is only a small part of the services provided by Grace Ledoux and her volunteers. So, I'm going to have everybody come up, so half the audience here. And please join me in congratulating the High River Hospital volunteers in winning the Volunteer of the Year group category.
Thank you.
That's why we had such a good turnout. It's a really good time for the rest of us to grab dessert. No lineup.
Recipient. As you can see, all of us aren't the youth here. So this, to me, that's not a jab. It's not a people have time and give time when they can. It's really important for me. I've got a couple of young guys at home. And when young people step out to do something in our community, it really means a lot and shows a lot to me. And I hope it shows a lot to our community. So this kind of leadership and representation in the community is outstanding. So I'm here this evening to present for Volunteer of the Year, the youth recipient. And that youth recipient this evening is Mackenzie Hogan. So Mackenzie has been a volunteer with the Town of High River Community Programs, Leader in Training, with our summer day camps for over 3 years. She has volunteered over 120 hours each summer since 2016. So to put this in perspective, as a student, she has July and August away from the classroom. So that's 15 hours a week and a significant total contribution of 360 hours in that time. So I just find that incredibly outstanding. Now, somebody made a point of it's not the hours that you contribute, and surely it's not. For the 1 hour that somebody in this room might have volunteered, or for the number that Mackenzie has done, that doesn't matter. It's the fact that you stepped up and did something for the community. But I couldn't step away without saying something about that. So she was described in her nomination as a leader whose work with children and assisting other leaders stood out above the rest and was exemplary. She was wonderful with the children, and they adored her. Mackenzie's influence is said to have made the summer day camps shine, not only for the kids, but also for her peers and leaders. I'm honored to recognize our Youth Volunteer of the Year, as it really does inspire me. Here is a young individual stepping up for the betterment of others in our community. Although volunteering is not about the recognition, but rather the desire to give of oneself, I would like to thank and recognize Mackenzie for her dedication and leadership. Please join me in congratulating Mackenzie on winning Volunteer of the Year Youth Category.
Also included letters of support from the High River Minor Baseball, High River Food Connections, and Food for Thought, to name just a few. Jason and Karen are from SOBE support local businesses within their businesses by carrying locally made products. They hire youth from our community, and they also support those with disabilities by offering an inclusive work environment. The staff at SOBE are encouraged and supported to volunteer in the community and give back as a team. On top of all the support they've given over the years, SOBE has recently become the food rescue program, and over the past 5 months has provided almost 25,000 pounds of food. Wow. And helped. I try to visualize with 25,000 pounds of food, that's a lot of food. And have helped over 1,700 citizens with
with fresh food items they normally couldn't afford. Thank you for helping feed our community. I have to talk off a little bit here, but I have to say that, Karen and Jason, I've known them for a long, long time, and they've always been involved in all the sporting organizations that I've been involved in, lacrosse, hockey, all those sorts of things. They've also been a big supporter of the balloon event. I'm really happy to present you with this award. Please come forward, Jason and Karen. This business has done amazing things in High River. They've done huge problems. They've developed a dam. Again, a big thanks to all of us in our community for being here this evening.
The font wasn't big enough. I've learned a theme tonight with our council. We can get an eyeglass sponsorship. That was my word. It's all about agenda items you're reading, hey? Okay. Congratulations again to Jason, Karen, and the entire Sobeys team as well. Thank you, Jamie Kinghorn, for being here tonight. Let's put your hands together now for our next presenter, Councillor Carol McMillan. Do you have your glasses? Good evening, everyone, and thank you, Jody. And all of you for attending. And above all, I just so honor all of the great work that volunteers do. The gift of time is so imperative, and no amount of financial resources can match the spirit and dignity of our awesome volunteers in High River. So tonight, I am very honored to be handing out the Volunteer of the Year Award for the adult category. And it's for Libby DeStere. And in her nomination, Libby is described as a kind, generous, compassionate, dependable, fun, and truthful person who has dedicated her time and talent to our community over the past 40 years. Libby has volunteered for the High River Youth Justice Committee for the past 7 years and is currently the case coordinator. She volunteers at the animal shelter and has shared her love of gardening and landscaping with yards around our community. She is also a volunteer member with Victim Services. As a school drama teacher, Libby has also recognized and encouraged many students over the years to participate in productions and climb out of their comfort zones. And although my two sons weren't involved in the drama program, I attended many of them, and I couldn't believe not only the quality of the productions, but above all, these youth that absolutely adored their drama teacher. And to me, that was a solid gold gift. Her guidance has helped many youth gain more confidence over the years. Libby is certainly a special person who inspires others around her. Please join me in congratulating her on winning Volunteer of the Year Adult category. Please put your hands together for Councillor Bruce Masterman.
Thank you, Jody. Just in case you're wondering, it is not a coincidence that I get to handle senior. It's wonderful to be here. I'm delighted to present this award to a guy that I consider a friend for almost 40 years. Ted, come on up here. You might as well be standing here while I'm going through all this stuff. I was supposed to keep it short, he said. Look at the height on this guy. It's just nice to not be the tallest person standing up. So I just have to say a couple of things. First met Top Ted in 1980, which was our Karen and I, our first full year in High River. And Ted and Maureen operated a commercial photography business. As a fellow photographer, I was just in awe of this guy. His incredible work behind the camera, in the dark room, in the studio, but mainly I admired Ted, the person. A good-hearted guy, always had a smile, a positive comment, and took general pride in his community. And that attitude has really helped define Ted for the entire time that I've known him. In the nomination for this award, Ted is described by the nominator as someone who shows enthusiasm and encouragement for his community. He shows by his efforts that he's proud to live in High River and wishes to make it a great place for all to live. Ted's been the chair of the Santa Claus Parade for 28 years this year.
Wow.
Started when he was 30. On any day throughout the year, if you ask Ted, I've been at many, many events where people have said to Ted, how many days till the next Santa Claus Parade? Yeah. And he knows. How many, Ted?
242.
242.
But more importantly, there's only 39 to the Little Bridges.
Nice lot to hang. These are brothers from a different mother base too. So Ted also coordinates the incredible parade, but also the incredible light up George Lane Park, which is in its sixth year coming up. He's also vice chair of the Little Britches Parade to keep Hank, Lee Frank in some kind of order. He's an active volunteer with the Rotary Club of High River, the High River United Church, including the Simple Supper, which is a monthly community supper that everybody can come to. Also volunteer with the River City Classics Car Club, and that's the Car Club, just to name a few. Ted, to me, really does personify all that is great about High River. We're really honored that Ted and Maureen chose High River to live in so many years ago and to raise their family here as well. Please join me in congratulating Ted on being named the senior volunteer.
He asked if I wanted to say anything. Big mistake. Like I said, 39 days to the Little Bridges Parade, 242 days to the Santa Claus Parade. So there's lots of great things happening. Please come out and be involved. But I'm really honored to receive this, but without the support of my wife, people like Hank, Ev Doherty, Ted Oakes, and Pat George from the Lions Club, and all of the folks that come together to help us do these things, it wouldn't happen. So thank you to everybody that's on the committees that I serve. So thank you.
Thank you.
Make him.
Maybe just make a note here not to have seniors hand over to seniors. Did you take my notes? No, you didn't. You did turn them. You messed them all up. Thank you again, Ted Dawson. Congratulations on the award. Thank you as well to the Council of Residents. Well, I'll leave you on a couple of notes. We want to steal a penny for your thoughts, and we even provided the pennies because we thought of everything on your way out tonight. We are asking, as a result of volunteering, volunteers feel more connected to the community. If you strongly agree to strongly disagree, if you could drop a penny in a jar on your way out tonight, we appreciate that. We are currently with the Arrowhead River Group. We're planning sort of a new strategy to help connect people with volunteering opportunities within the community. There is a Facebook group for those of you on Facebook called High River Volunteer Opportunities, where you can connect. Post information on volunteers you're looking for. If you're seeking, if you have time to give, you can post in there. We're creating a community for you to talk. And then coming soon, we're hoping to create a directory online so that you can just log on and see opportunities within the community. If you need some help, I think all of you are probably pretty taxed in the room, but if you go home and tell other people who weren't here, if they'd like to connect with some volunteer ideas, to contact us at Arrowhead River, and we'd love to help coordinate some ideas with you there. You're welcome to stay tonight and get more photos, eat more food, have more fun. I want to take a quick moment to thank Shelley and Fauna and Cindy for their help setting up and getting things organized tonight. If we could give them a big round of applause. And then I would love it if you would give an incredible roof blasting round of applause to Janelle Kennedy, who is your community development coach of the town of High River. She has been incredible to our world. And I need to get as many brownie bonus points. I was having a hard time, brownie bonus points, because I sit right behind her and annoy her every day. But she was integral in putting tonight's event on for you and worked very hard to ensure that you had an incredible night. So one more round of applause for you. And because I really love quotes, one more before you go, a thought from Anne Frank that says, "How wonderful it is that nobody need wait a single moment before starting to improve our world." Thank you for making High River the best town in this world. Have a good night.